Hello and welcome to this episode of MakerBox Mondays. Today I'm going to have a look at a filament from Colorfab called Laser Marking PLA. So let's have a look after intro. So looking at the label, here they say it's called Laser Marking PLA. Hot end temperatures should be 190 to 220. Bed 50 to 60, speed 40 to 100, cooling 100%. Other experimental material, so pretty much PLA settings, so to speak of. But here they say laser marking PLA contains laser sensitive attractive optimized to work within 980 to 1064 nanometer wavelength. This material has been tested successfully with NDYAG and fiber lasers. I have no idea what that is. Laser marking PLA will not work with CO2 lasers. So this is some material I have no idea on what to use for, but I tried to print some parts with it, so let's have a look at them. First did sear laser lot. That came out pretty nice. There was no issues to speak of. Just it looks like a light gray or white PLA. So no issues here, and I don't have any lasers to experiment with, so I don't know how to test those properties of this filament, but for a PLA it just looks really nice, and the print came out excellent. And then did a Benchy, and that came out quite good as well. There were some issues here. I don't know what was going on, but if it was something with my printer, you can see the lines there, but other than that the Benchy came out pretty nice. I had some failures with Benchys and some blobs. That was due to bed adhesion. I had to clean my bed and prepare it again. It was no fault of the filament, but because I had this issue, I didn't have much filament left, so and I was doing the Otis model by Gareth, I ran out of filament. But besides it, missing the top part, the print came out excellent. Really smooth surface and really good looking. So this was just my fault. Therefore I didn't have enough filament to finish this model. So for PLA, I was quite happy with this filament. There was just no issues. I used Colorfab materials before and I have been quite happy with them overall. So for a PLA from Colorfab, it just performs really good. But like I said, the laser properties or experiments that need to be done for this filament to make a proper review, I don't know what to do in that regard. Those laser properties is something I have no idea about, but that's fun. But for this video, this will be it. I thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one.